Hi there, I'm Justin, and welcome to another chapter in Road Choice Clutch Technical Training. This program deals with the clutch envelope and answers the big question, do you need a fiber spacer? Let's start with a quick definition. The term clutch envelope refers to the distance between the flywheel and the input shaft bearing retainer. This dimension increases over time due to wear and resurfacing of the flywheel, so with a clutch installation, we always ask, do we need a fiber spacer to adjust the envelope? And in case you're wondering what a fiber spacer is, well, here you go. A fiber spacer is an 1/8-inch thick spacer used to compensate for material loss due to resurfacing of the flywheel or wear on the input shaft bearing retainer. This spacer installs on the input shaft against the input shaft bearing retainer prior to the clutch brake. Now, here's why a fiber spacer is important. When a truck is new, the distance from the flywheel to the input shaft bearing retainer is a set dimension, and the flywheel sets in the flywheel housing 2.5 inches. When a flywheel has been resurfaced, this dimension increases because of the material lost during the grinding process. This means that by the time the new clutch is installed, the release bearing has moved farther away from the clutch brake. If a fiber spacer isn't used, it would be necessary to adjust the clutch to make up for that wear or loss of material in the flywheel and input shaft bearing retainer. But adjusting the clutch during installation is not something that we recommend. We recommend installing a fiber spacer with every clutch replacement. In fact, the spacer is included with each unit. Now, if you forget to install the fiber spacer at clutch installation, you can still do so without having to remove the transmission. The spacer will be scored, showing you where to cut a V-notch in it. Once cut, it'll twist and install over the input shaft. Now, if the clutch was adjusted at installation and the 1/2-inch to 5/8-inch dimension between the clutch cover and release bearing is not correct, the clutch can be readjusted counterclockwise to achieve the 1/2-inch to 5/8-inch dimension. Adding the fiber spacer between the input bearing retainer and the clutch brake will achieve the desired 1/2-inch dimension. Here's how to remove the spacer. If a spacer was installed and the 1/2-inch gap between the clutch brake and the release bearing is too small, the fiber spacer can be easily removed by using a chisel or screwdriver with a hammer. Simply put it on and drive through till it's broken. A fiber spacer is a great way to create the required clutch envelope, but there's one other way to achieve the same thing, and that's by using an oversized clutch brake. The bottom line is, regardless if you use a fiber spacer or an oversized clutch brake, these dimensions must be maintained for proper clutch setup. Okay, that's it for this chapter. I hope you'll explore the other chapters in this clutch technical training series to make sure your clutch knowledge is up to date. You'll find all the parts information you need at roadchoice.com, and you can always contact us directly with questions about what you've learned here. This is Justin for Road Choice Truck Parts, and I'll see you next time.